less conscious that it was walking right down my top.
Okay. But it's actually now recording. Oh.
Down your top.
Bonus. I'm naked and juicy.
That's a G5 with a super wide angle lens. Right. So.
It's a family picture.
The first data pad, with the terms of the deal, effectively, it deals with what you get is that you will get free refuel and edible supplies at any company outpost.
Do we get free shunt drives? Because we seem to
buy free shunt drives. You get a monthly stipend of 15 grand each.
Mm-hmm.
And a 50% discount on any repairs or goods purchased from the company.
Does the company cost more, though?
No, but the quality is worth it. Okay. Or if they do cost more, then
it is
worth it. Basically, they've got branches that deal with pretty much everything.
If there's something that you wouldn't be able to get on the black market, you'd get it through them.
Do we have expenses? Okay.
But you would also...
get finder's fees and things like
theory,
that.
Theory, yeah. Yeah, if there are any additional contracts. The other thing is that you would get company rank.
Okay.
Not particularly high, and it would only be a kind of...
Ensign Crusher!
Don't I already have that, though?
Yeah, it's one grade higher than you're on at the moment.
Promotion! Climb that corporal ladder.
I'm taking it.
Yeah, which... is I didn't actually write down what the rank would be, but effectively it would be like a not a directorship, it would be
apprenticeship.
Yeah, there's a name that goes with it.
It's an internship.
Than... yeah,
we're paid interns.
I was even less than an intern when I first started.
We are Viari.
Oh, I'm sorry, that doesn't make sense. Paid interns.
Well, you get intern credit. You get your college credit.
Yeah, so we have interns.
To the friends and family of intern Dana, our thoughts go out with you. Kareem is still with them after nearly 2 months, because he was with them before the Beagle.
Night Vale?
Okay. I do not know. Night Vale community radio interns have a life expectancy somewhere shorter than a Spinal Tap drummer.
Dude.
Right. Night Vale. I'm gonna download a couple of.
The fact that Naomi loves it, the crap out of it, it does. Loves it that I don't trust.
Continue.
Thomas, yep. But
the
pretty cool. So.
So effectively, that's going to give you, you know, people that you can contact. And. Safe havens, bolt holes, that sort of thing.
So we've got, in some ways, being on the side of the. Company also so because we're semi whatever contractors, if we do need to do things that don't necessarily involve the company but not in that kind of backstabbing kind of way,
mm-hmm.
we can do that and no one would know that we're actually part of the company
unless you go around flashing your company badges,
which I don't like doing anyway.
Is it
no,
I'm feeding it to the autofac.
You don't actually have a badge.
I'm just going to make one, just so you can specially feed it to the autofac.
Okay, I'm quite liking the terms of this deal. I think this is favourable.
I'm back where I need to be. In my plan of things, this is very favourable.
It gives me the opportunity to potentially help a lot of people, so I'm quite happy about that. And it means I get to keep flying without having to look over my shoulder thinking that the company's going to come and drop the heavy end of the hammer on me. I like that as well.
I like being a mercenary. It gives me the opportunity to pick and choose the contracts I want because I don't want them to kind of conflict with my ideology.
It allows you to visit people of an ancient and noble culture and kill them.
I like it because it means I get foods and I get to blow stuff up. And then I get to learn how about I'm blowing stuff up so I can blow more stuff up more efficiently.
I'm paid.
Cha-ching, bling, win-win bling, dala-dala.
So happy. So what's the first job?
The first job.
We're okay. required to manoeuvre straight down this trench.
The jump web. Effectively the means by which you move from planet to planet.
Mm-hmm.
That there. Or system to star system. Navigating it is one of the biggest, not problems, because most of the jump routes are, and the wormholes that connect the labyrinth are relatively stable.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the wormholes are trickier to navigate than others. Some of them are easier than others. And there are a lot of wormholes that lead to a lot of places that you just, people haven't bothered exploring. Like that first system that you found when you found that derelict ship, for example. One thing that has never really been nailed down is A, what created them, or several things that have never been nailed down. A, what created the labyrinth, and B, any way to predict them. Because even on green routes, there is a chance that things are going to go wrong. There's always a chance that you're going to come across, you know, problems in hyperspace, failure of your shunt drive, various different things. The fact that it is an extra dimensional space, it causes issues. There have been many legends of a map of the entirety of the labyrinth. This is something that contains and can predict the coordinates and the exit points and give you the easiest routes to travel from one system to another system. Not so much a Marauder's map, that just showed real time where people were. What we're talking about is
the cosmic key for Masters of the Universe.
See, in my head, this is the Illuvian network in Dragon Age, but
for me, it's the Mass Effect relays.
That's true. Yeah, similar thing almost, but not Mass Effect.
Was it built by Reapers? Are they going to come every 3,000 years?
No, we don't want Reapers.
No Reapers, not yet.
No. Was that those things that we saw in the first?
No? See, that's what I'm thinking.
Right.
Was it them?
The,
or the spiky chatter people that did it?
This map has been described and you've heard of it beforehand. It's either a mathematical representation as a way to work out instantaneously ways from A to B, or it's a physical thing that allows you to stabilize wormholes. Or it's
a holy grail actual people don't really know.
Physical map, yeah.
It's a map. It's got special abilities. We need to find Jack Sparrow.
More rum!
It's Dora. Dora's map. Dora grew up and died and left the map.
Dora didn't do much exploring because she always had a map. That means people have already been there. You're a liar, Dora.
But so something must have changed for this to be no longer just a myth and a nothing, for them to actually take real credence in it.
Have they got any idea of where it might be?
They have a lead, which Adjutant Vathach thinks is a little bit more real.
Solid.
A little bit more solid than anything else.
Okay.
The map, basically, it's a name. And this is the first time that it's been...
The map is a name?
The map has been given a name.
Oh.
And for whatever reason, the company have decided that they are willing to spend money and send people in as retrieval experts or just people to find it.
Indiana Jones study.
Yeah.
It belongs in a museum.
Being guarded.
Top men.
Yeah. Who?
Top men. The Jones. Shut up, Porkins. Okay. So where is this lead?
The name that's been given is the Worlogog.
Worlogog. I can do a quick Google search on this. Mm-hmm. No hits?
Nope.
It's a Google whack.
It's a Google whack.
Okay. The lead itself, has it got a location attached to it? Has it surfaced in a particular system? Anywhere to start? Or
the name and the data files came from a ship that exited shunt space in the Braddon system. And it had come back from Sasellum.
So that's two jumps.
That's just there.
Mm-hmm. Do we know the name of the ship?
Hmm?
The name of the ship?
It went by the name the Intrepid.
Okay.
That's not an ominous name.
Well, Navy's had many Intrepids. It's fine.
Hmm? Sorry.
It was an Explorer class vessel. The Sasellum system is thought to have many jump routes. It's only the fact that it itself is quite difficult to get to.
Hmm. Okay. I'm thinking that we take this on. I'm thinking also if it turns out to be some sort of algorithm or something like that, or like, you know, a piece of software rather than a physical thing, we might want to make a copy of that for our own ship.
Even though we know its name, we still don't know its nature.
You weren't here when we were talking about it. I asked Ross about what's working for this guy like. Basically, if you're honest with him, he's good with you. If you double cross him or whatever, he is known to be a harsh fucker. So.
I like how you said mother under your breath.
Yeah, that was
but not the other one.
That's how bad he is.
Well done. Okay, I'm all for it. I think we should do it. I'm excited by this plan.
When I've been spending my money drinking it up and making friends,
mm-hmm.
Have I heard anything? Have I met anybody that I could ask? Just any more information?
There's going to be people that are, you know the phrase, there are old mercenaries and bold mercenaries, but there are no old bold mercenaries.
Yeah.
You've got people who have been around for an awful long time. They tend to be the pilots and not the ground troops, so sometimes they're a little bit standoffish with you, but there's going to be people that you can ask.
Yeah. Can I go ask them then? Yeah.
When I'm hyperlinked, I form a single consciousness. So when I was hyperlinked, did I get anything?
It forms a single consciousness with all of the other Ithkal that you're hyperlinked with at the time.
Yeah, so when I was doing my swimming pool full of otters, mm-hmm. holding hands, I presume there was a lot of us. Did we?
It only takes, what, 4 or 5? So there may have been 10 or 20.
Yeah.
But there's nothing that you actively remember as being.
Okay. I'm out. I got nothing.
Is that pear squash?
Yeah.
That's cute.
Lovely.
I'm thinking we contact.
Can I just have an ask of the peoples?
Yeah, sure.
Do I have to take anything?
Yeah, it will be. this is going to be mind and cunning.
3. 3.
And I'm on 5, play 1.
How many do I play? I play the
number equal to your mind score.
Okay.
What?
I'm going to play an 8, which brings me up to 11.
And what did I say? 5?
Yeah.
This one goes to 11.
Yeah, of course, Thomas has just seen my hand because I'm trying to show it to the camera, but not to anybody else. There you go. So there's eight. So, amongst all of the people that you are talking to, there is a very experienced drop pilot who was a commercial flight leader before he started doing kind of hot drops and so on. And he kind of responds to the message that you put out to the kind of bulletin board or whatever server it was with quite a tersely worded message saying that shit's just a legend. That is, you know, it's like Space Kraken. It's like the legend of
Zelda.
You know, the legend of legend of finding a second Earth. It's so pie in the sky that it just doesn't bear thinking about. If it did, it would be worth more than the sum total of the company, full stop. If.
I don't mind just giving this to someone else.
There's many folks that have chased after this. They either wind up crazy, or dead, or both.
Why would he be so aggressive against it, though?
A very tersely worded email.
He knows something.
He knows something.
Well, I can always hit him with the poop gun until he tells us.
Just playing devil's advocate, it might not be that he knows something. It might be that he has lost friends and allies going off on downfall crusades with that Obi-Wan.
Yeah, but I put this message out to however many people I've met over my 4 days, which is quite a lot because I've been drinking quite a lot. But I've made a lot of like friends on that area, and we got, you know, the very nature of mercenaries. You go to certain pubs and you always travel into the system, but you do meet up with the same people at the same places. And out of everybody, he's the only one who said anything, and it's like almost not worth saying. So why would he have said it?
Do you want to go pay him a visit?
Maybe.
You can go pay him a visit.
Go pay him a visit. Go pay him a visit.
Okay.
We'll go.
I'm suggesting the kid gloves, not poop glove approach.
Yeah, no. Absolutely.
Kid gloves are made of kid,
I think,
leather.
I'm going to go down the track to kind of...
So it's very soft.
Like I just said to you, you know, nobody said anything, and you've said this, and it's almost not worth saying. I've been given a load of money to, okay, it might be a fool's errand, but I've still been paid for it. What's the problem? Like, professional to professional.
Just a quick thing. As we are taking this job on, do we need to have told Mr. Sharpsy?
Yeah, it would be nice to say.
Yeah.
To actually say,
also,
we're on it.
Is it a secret job? Should we not have told everybody that this is what we're looking for?
Well, we haven't come out, at least I haven't come out and said to people, I am looking for this.
No.
But just, I presume you've worded it in, oh, I've been hearing rumours about this, whatever, is there anything to it?
Yeah. But have we been told it's secret? Can I tell him that I've been...
I presume it's secret.
Yeah, we can't say that.
And
it's
if we're supposed to be a deniable group for the company, maybe advertising that we've been...
Well, yeah, but it might
not
be.
Turning around and saying, okay, the company are paying us to... You know, we're being paid a lot of money to try and find this. Possibly not the best line to use.
Yeah. But I could be saying, we are being paid a lot of money to find this. No, it's not about who buy.
The problem is, though, who's got that kind of money to pay for it? Whereas if you just say, oh, we've... You know, heard something about it. I know a guy that might be interested. Oh, are we just chasing smoke, or is there something to this? What do you know?
Yeah. All right.
Okay. You head off to
see anything about that secret customer's secret illegal account. Oh crap!
So you head to one of the cities on one of the other continents where he's known to hang out. Find a bar and spend some time waiting for him. And yeah, he's in there, in between contacts, or in between contracts. Can't speak at all today. And he kind of looks up. Looks a bit funny. Who's going in there?
I'm going to stay with the ship in case
we
need to get out of here.
Yeah.
I'm still locked up in my room.
You're not locked up in your room. They don't just let you out at weekends.
I may... lock him.
Well, no, my room is a holding cell.
New city, you can be fixing the limo.
Yeah, okay.
I'll buy me two drinks.
Yeah. You now have a low rider.
On a limo.
We've got hydraulics on it now, so we can do the whole.
Turned it into a transformer.
And a bitching sound system. And a PS4.
Pierced, 4 to the power of 10 or something. he recognises you from the, you know, the short time that we spent together. So, and when you get there, he's kind of half into his cups already.
He's part drunk already.
He's an old guy. If you imagine, he's played by the guy that plays Rorschach and Odin Green Cannon.
Jackie O'Haley.
Grizzled. Very grizzled. And very old. And really quite short. If you imagine a mean version of your dad.
Okay.
I don't think I can do that.
Jackie O'Haley is kind of like if somebody took your dad and put him in the oven for about 15 hours, so it kind of like shrinked up and shriveled up.
And then turned him in.
Yeah, like tough, like shoe leather. Like a $2 steak.
Okay. $2 steak. With that image in my mind.
Why?
Why what?
Why are you asking questions about something that is just horse pucky?
Why are you so adamant that it's horse pucky? If, you know, I've seen people chase after it before, we've all seen people chase after it before, but is there mistakes to make? Why are you telling me so strongly? It really feels like you know something else.
He sighs, reaches into his pocket, pulls a little wallet out, activates a holo display. Him and a guy that looks very, very similar to him, arm in arm.
Brother.
Went chasing after it. Not heard back from him.
When did he go?
50 years ago. Now, I'm afforded the luxury of being known as a good pilot. I am a good pilot. I'm still here. You know, 338 combat drops, 22 years of civvy service beforehand. I still pray to my God every time I open up a jump drive. Every time I start the shunt drive going, every time I open up a wormhole, the very idea of something that would mean that becomes as easy as walking across the bar to get me a drink, I'll just laugh that to you, it would be greatly appreciated, but I ain't stupid.
Okay.
Possibly ask about where his brother...
His brother went off to find it and hasn't come back. Was his brother called Chester Copperpot?
No.
Oh. Goonies.
I know.
Damn.
Where did your brother look?
On a system I would never fly to.
Being.
Salem.
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 Mm-hmm.
And why wouldn't you fly there?
Well, that's where he went before he disappeared.
Huh. Well, that's... If I ever hear from him, I'll let you know.
Yeah.
Thank you for your time. Mm.
Been nice knowing you.
I'll buy him another drink.
We'll be fine. I'm an amazing driver.
So that's the past we've lost three shunt drives.
Two.
So.
And one of them was lost saving all of your asses from the ambush at the container crates. You're welcome.
And who decided to do the fancy manoeuvres with...
No, that's fine. I'll just let the bad guy shoot you next time.
Joss, I'm surprised you haven't done that already.
How many airlocks does the kidney have?
One.
Excellent. Do you want to test its integrity? Right.
I really don't want to draw on your face while you're hooked up to the ship.
I'm thinking. She's dangerous. So we're face down random bio monster things. We've gone into the middle of nowhere trying to find something that kidnapped people and found them. I'm pretty certain.
No, just because it disappeared doesn't mean that something's like protecting it. Because, like we've just said, people can fall out of this hyperspace thing.
Yeah,
people
just get
lost.
Yeah.
Here be dragons.
So, travelling to that place via hyperspace
is more risky than
but
travelling.
But the thing is, the ship where we got this hit from stopped off. You know, it came from here, which is right there. So, at the very least, we can go here, see if we can find this ship, or news of the ship, and see what we can learn. And then, yeah.
Yeah.
And then we're one difficult jump away from the system that I can't read the other way.
Sasellum.
Oh, what? Because my brain's probably not jumped. So the ship that we originally went looking for...
We haven't gone looking for a ship yet. The hit, where we got the name of this thing, which I can't pronounce.
Worlogog.
The Worlogog.
Oh, right, okay.
The intel that we got from that was a ship that had jumped in from Sasellum and went to the Braddon system.
Yeah.
So I'm saying, at the very least, if we go to the Braddon system, we can find out, see if we can find this ship, see if we can find the crew of the ship, or whatever, and get some information. And then we're one jump away from Sasellum if we need to
go there. Nope, not that bad.
And it's a relatively straight run. We're basically going down the Space M6, so we're fine.
Yeah, but you've got the Spaghetti Junction Central in the middle.
So that's why you just want the A1. So much straight.
But if we get the Worlogog, maybe that will have all the B roads on it as well. So we can avoid the main routes and take the cross-country routes that are quicker.
It's Space Ways.
Okay. Yeah, that makes sense.
So are we going to Braddon?
Yeah.
Fantastic. So, we have two jumps. Are you going to try and find a cargo or just... We don't need cargo, we're rich.
I'm not rich enough that
I'll
turn up free.
I say we still do the mundane every day
The other thing as well is, if somebody asks why are we going to Braddon, we're doing the delivery.
Yeah, that keeps our cover.
Keeps our cover, and we can add a little bit of extra credits. So let's take something that's low risk.
Yeah. Legal, because we're now working with them.
You know, so let's carry some space turnips. What do they need in Braddon? Nylons. I'm just thinking the Cold War. We're taking VCRs and nylons and Nikes. Should I use my profession skill to find a job?
What's your mind plus profession?
Mind plus profession is 5.
Yeah, that's you can find a job.
So, yeah, we're moving VCRs, tape decks, holographic players, Madonna CDs. I'm sure she's still about at this point.
This is the 41st millennium. Madonna has just released another live album.
Oh, God, that's horrible. It's the 41st millennium. The Iron Throne isn't keeping the Emperor alive. It's Madonna. It's been Madonna the whole time. The Emperor protects. I just made myself really sad. It's okay. Let's
just scrub a little bit in your mouth. Okay, we've got two jumps.
So, jump to central first.
Yep. I'm on 5+1.
I'm on 7, and I can play 2, so I'm going to lowball it first, so that's 7 and 6 is a number, because maths has just failed me. 13.
9.
Beautiful.
Simples?
Simples. So we're there. So we've made central. And now we need to go to Braddon. Yep. So that's
5 plus 1 again.
7 plus 9, so that's 16.
Okay, and I go, math, 12.
Excellent. So that beats it by 5 as well. So I don't know if that means we get their lickety split. We grow an extra shunt drive if that's successful.
No.
The kitty says
you want to buy an organic ship?
Well, no. No, no, I don't want an organic ship. No, 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 no.
But then you...
No.
No, Thomas. We'll wake up Izzy deliberately just so she can come down and say, no.
Oh, I dare not incur that wrath.
Yeah.
She's properly putting her hands on her hips and scowling at me the other day as well. Right, we're in Braddon. My job here is done. I've delivered her safely. It's time for you losers to earn your keep. I mean, good luck on your endeavour.
Okay. Braddon is a binary star system.
Yay.
So you've got two planets orbiting roughly almost at Lagrange points to each other.
Okay.
On opposite sides of the thing. It's a very eccentric orbit pattern. Known for, well, one of them is known for being a very industrialised system, and the other one is actually, because it's quite close to central, it's quite a high wealth resort planet. The industrialised planet has been almost totally, you know, veggie formed and terraformed and whatever, so you've got a massive amount of orbital engineering works, all of its
skyhooks, all that sort of thing.
Yeah, all of its asteroids trailing and leading are, you know, mined. You've got extensive high orbital systems. The other one, they try to keep as pristine as possible. Obviously, there's a spaceport. Effectively, yeah. But because it's orbiting a binary star system, and because of the way that you've got two planets effectively on the same orbital path, it's got a crazy couple of moons, and its tides are all over the shop, which means, surf's up, dudes!
It's surf paradise!
Yeah.
So, did we get a name of the ship that had come?
It was the Intrepid.
The Intrepid, we did get a name. So I think the first thing that we need to do is, which of the planets would the Intrepid have been made for first?
Pretty much all ships would go, unless they are tourist liners,
yeah,
will go straight for Alpha, which is the industrialised one.
Okay, so, Birmingham then. So let's go to Alpha then, and I presume it's a little bit like the Intrepid. I know what I'm thinking. I just can't put it into words. So like, if I get the newspaper today, I can see what ships are sailing and what ships are due in, and this and that and the other thing, you know. And it's a matter of public record. So is there something similar here, or is it because it's a bit more, you know, is the Intrepid like a chartered sort of thing?
No.
Or is it a personally owned?
Calling up the logs, the Intrepid was registered against it's a company registered ship, and it's an Explorer class. It is big.
Okay.
It's very big. Like, so mind-boggling, imagine huge. You might think it's a long way. No.
How many
like
Enterprise?
Big? No. Bigger. No. No, Babylon 5, Russ Tamblyn's ship, the Explorer class one, the one that they had to move the jump gates apart for.
Yeah.
It's that size.
Jesus.
Okay. Is it still here?
What's left of it is.
Oh, great.
I say it came back out, and it came through.
Partially.
So, questions.
So if it's still in. It like got cut off on it.
Maybe half of it's still there. So we need to get information off this ship. I presume there's still crew knocking about, so we could try and find some of the crew and have a chat with them.
Well, but surely often they do it like that. They're all kind of ooh nah.
That's a technical term, isn't it?
Yeah.
Are you referring to PTSD, perhaps?
Mm-hmm.
Post-traumatic stress disorder.
Yeah, I know what it stands for. It could be that. It could be they're insane. It could be that they've just drank a lot.
PTSD.
The other thing is, what's your remote hacking like? Can we hack the computer back to the ship without landing on it?
She can.
Do we want to try that first? I'll fly past, like, casual.
Company, so I couldn't see why we couldn't.
Because we're not supposed to be advertising that we're working for the company. You don't get this whole free
No, I know that it is, but I can go in.
Isabel was trying to sneak around and she literally went tiptoe, tiptoe.
Sorry, when?
A couple of days ago. Oh. She was trying to sneak somewhere. She went tiptoe, tiptoe, tiptoe. She wasn't even tiptoeing though, she was crawling.
So do you want to...
It was sneaking.
Do you want to... Try that then. I'll fly casual past it and you try and see if you can get.
But what I meant was, is that I can go in, and I'm not going to be like blatant about it, but I can cover it that it looks like that it's a.
You're going to use your password and username.
No, she's going to be like, Supernatural Boys, pretending that they're from the FBI or from. Although we are from the company, pretending we're officially from the company to kind of get stuff in.
Yeah. Oh, like a double bluff.
Yeah.
Okay.
So I thought it was just going to be like a Jehovah's Witness person and just walk right in the door and say, hey, we're here now.
Space Avon would work better.
Space Avon.
Yeah, Space Avon.
Do you remember? Your scales not shine like they used to.
Do you remember Mortal Kombat 2, back in the day, one of the stages, there was a big floaty window and there was a sort of like, you know, robed monk floating out there. And Games Master magazines went, bloody Avon, get everybody used to this. I laughed so hard. So anyway, yeah. I'm flying casual.
I just had a really random thought in my head. I was like, does anyone remember Amway?
Yeah, I remember Amway.
Yeah.
No,
it just popped in my head because...
There were... a pyramid selling thing. They were mostly cleaning products.
Yeah, my nan used to do it.
And it was, the whole idea was that you would be an Amway representative and you'd sell it to your friends, but you could then get other people to buy stuff in bulk off you and then they could resell it, and it's pyramid selling.
Joy.
It's a bit like Herbalife.
Juice Plus.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, it just popped up in my head because Grandad's in my head and Nan popped in my head. Avon was like, my mind, natural progression. Anyway.
Okay. So you get up to sort of the hacking distance.
Yep.
The ship is in a very high orbit. Okay. Giving Brad's alpha, because effectively it's bigger than most space stations. You couldn't dock anything. It's a sort of size ship that you had to shuttle the crew on and off. It's almost space station sized itself. And as Natalia thought or mentioned, the rear end of the ship, it's not just like the shunt drives have been knocked off it, it's sheared clean off. The ship should be another, I don't know, 600 or 700 meters longer with its main shunt drives at the back end of it.
It's almost as if the portal
The wormhole closed
on it,
on top of it, and the only thing that could do that is that if something got the shunt drives whilst it was in the wormhole.
Dude. Not scared.
Pikes.
The rest of the ship. Hey, what do you want a ship with no shunt drive for? You can't go anywhere in it.
Check dags.
So I want to kind of try and hack in some kind of like black box kind of thing, see what happens, you know, what the transmissions were at that time, if there was any anomalies with systems when that occurred. So, you know, things that would point out to like what could have...
The rest of the ship, sorry, just as you're doing the flyby, because you need to get... relatively close. Okay, your normal rig can only hack a certain distance. Using the ship's comm systems, you've got a little bit extra range on it, but you still need to be close to the front end where all the computer cores are.
I could rig up a thingy with my technical...
You don't really need to. It's just a question of plugging her hacking rig into the ship's main comm system. And which is just like a USB connector. So,
take it out,
put it in the other way around.
Schrodinger's USB.
No, it's USB type C. Bisexual USB, it goes both ways.
Yeah, I guarantee I will still be stood there for 10 minutes going.
You're alright then, because it's me plugging it in.
The rest of the ship is well used. According to public service logs, this ship's been in circulation for about 60 years. So it shows a regular amount of
wear and tear.
Patching and wear and tear for a ship that's been going for that long. Maybe it's got a few bits and upgrades around the non-standard things like replacement AE-43 main sensor dishes and so on and so forth. But otherwise, it's in fairly good nick apart from the fact that half it's missing. If you can do a 10 play 2. And I am on 5 play 2. So you want link hacking. Plus hacking, yeah.
So 7.
And what did I say? 10?
Yeah. You said 10 at one point, then you said 5 at the other point. So I'm not
okay,
really sure.
I'll go for 7 then. Split the difference.
We're at 18, and it being a computer card.
Yep.
Matching my
affinity.
So you draw another one.
And it matches the ambience, doesn't it? Because she's
yep. trying to look so in. It's so draw 2, keep two, on sack one. So what do you say you're on? 18?
Yeah.
Well, that puts it back down to 7.
Okay. Okay.
20. 17. So you get in. Okay, so you manage a very brief link, and you manage to grab logs for the last 7 days. I'm going to leave it there.
Oh.
Thank you.
That was awesome.